I'm Aaron Baker from PhoneDog.com, and the Oppo Find 5 is finally in the office, and all the way from China to boot. Let's take a look at it in the full unboxing. Here it is, the Oppo Find 5, and you tech heads probably know exactly what this phone is, but Oppo is not available in the US, at least on the mobile side. They're known primarily for Blu-ray players in the US, but we got their phone in PhoneDog West, fresh from China. Just came in this afternoon, so special thanks to Oppo for the review unit, and special thanks, let's see if we can get it there. Challenging box to open. You see Oppo on the exterior, and special thanks to David Barron for hooking me up and helping me with my emails, emailing Oppo for the review unit. Special thanks to him. He's a good guy. I tucked him in one time in Vegas. Ask him about that. I appreciate him facilitating everything because I get too many emails as is. So it was nice of him to do that. Here it is, Oppo Find 5. Before we go too far, special thanks to our partners at Best Buy Mobile for giving us devices like this and we're using our One Paw Bandit giveaway game. When you go into Best Buy Mobile, you'll walk out working. You're not gonna get an Oppo Find 5, but you walk in to get something else from one of the major carriers, and you will walk out working. They'll get you all set up. Specs-wise here, looking at a quad-core 1.5 gigahertz CPU, you've got a 1.9 megapixel front-facing camera, 13 megapixel rear-facing camera. This thing is 0.35 inches thick, has a 5-inch 1080p HD display, and a really nice box, too. Pretty snazzy, if I do say so myself. It opens up Oppo Find 5. It's kind of like 5 gum. I feel like they should have packed some 5 gum with this. And then you've got Questure screen protectors as well. So here it is. Ooh, shiny and nice. Let's listen to this. Oh, man. Did you hear that? That was awesome. I don't know why I'm still whispering, but really a nice looking device here. Menu, home, and back. Gorgeous device with your volume rocker on the right side. Your what looks like a power button on the left side. Micro SIM card slot. 3.5 millimeter headphone jack up top and then 13 megapixel camera on the back. And you can see my reflection of my hair. That's pretty cool. Oppo. And we're gonna let that power up and we'll take a look at what comes in the box. Over here, NFC tags, important information guide that most people probably aren't going to read. I will do my best to read it though. And then you got a USB cable right here, some earbuds, and then an AC adapter module as well over here on the side. Kind of similar to the iPhone 4, 4S, and 5 AC adapter module in a lot of different ways. But here's the Oppo Find 5 continuing along on our little specifications track. Android 4.1 Jelly Bean out of the box. Has the Adreno 320 GPU, so keep that in mind as well. 2,500 milliamp hour non-removable battery. Ooh, schnazzy. And then here is the Find 5. So again, very customized version of Android 4.1. A little bit different in terms of a look and feel. Kind of has an iPhone-esque look and feel, at least in terms of the overall metal build quality in some places, glass, and then of course the big icons over here. So if you're coming from maybe an iPhone 5, this is something that'll kind of sink your teeth into Android and get you familiar with Android, but still kind of resembles that iPhone look and feel, at least right there out of the box. Hey there, how are you doing? And I am typing. There's my notification bar. Here are my settings as well. So again, a very heavily customized version of Android that we'll put through the paces in a full PhoneDog video review and most likely some dog fights as well. You can see that the settings are organized by general, sound, display, and personal. Let's see what's in each one. General, typical wireless and network stuff, system, sound, all the sound stuff with tones, display, home screen. Let's take a look at some of the personalization stuff on this device. You got your launcher. And that looks like that's about all you get in the home screen. Lock screen style, and we got fonts as well. I can change the font to small if I want to, some notes. And then I've got sleep, brightness, all the stuff you would expect right there. So let's press and hold the home button. We've got our task manager right there, customized task manager, and I can sweep it all up and get rid of the stuff that is taking up memory. But all around, a really nice device. Feels great in the hand. 5-inch display, travel, much like the Galaxy S4. Kind of hard to get that thumb all the way across, but just barely stretches to meet it. Like I said, power button on the left, and here's what it looks like when you power it on. Keyboard looked to be stock Android 4.1 Jelly Bean keyboard. Let's take a look again. Yep, sure is. And you can see portrait to landscape mode, that quad-core processor. Should transfer, let's see. May not be turned on out of the gate. Rotation, no, it looks like it's turned on. Let's see what it's doing. I don't know why it's not rotating properly, but that's okay. We'll put in a SIM card and take a look for further testing. You can edit this up here, it looks like really nice, and change some of the stuff around the status bar. So if I use GPS, for example, more than Wi-Fi, I can change it around. You know what, I use airplane mode quite a bit because I'm constantly on the road,
And then I can come up here and see that much like, again, like the Galaxy S4, the newer version of TouchWiz, and then LG's done this for some time, I can customize those icons up top and make the device my own. Here's your dialer as well, and then contacts, groups, and favorites. Really a clean looking font too. It's a good looking device. I'm hoping it performs as well as it looks like it will. Hopefully we'll find out in the full review and we'll take a look at it against other devices on the market like the Galaxy Note 2, the Galaxy S4, LG Optimus G Pro when it comes in, and all the different devices. But really, a slick looking unit all around. It feels great in the hand. Like I said, 0.35 inches thick, but it's still got a nice high-end build quality to it that really gives it, at 5.82 ounces, really makes it feel like a nice Android phone. Kind of like the HTC One, but if you're in a country where either it's not available or you know, you don't want the HTC One, you have something against HTC, this could be a nice alternative for you. And it even has cool sound effects. Can't beat that. Let's take a look at the widgets too and see what it looks like out of the box. Cool sound effects. Press and hold. Let's get our widgets up here. I actually do not know settings. Where are our widgets? Let's try over here. Widgets, there we go, by menu. And then bam, there we go. Music, contacts, calendar, photos, power control, traffic, Google Plus, all the stuff you would expect along with wallpapers. Let's change it over to Midnight City. Ooh, that's a good looking wallpaper. Keep it locked on phonedog.com for continuing coverage of the Oppo Find 5. We'll have reviews, dogfights, and more of this device fresh in from China. Glad to have it here in the Phone Dog offices. I'm on Twitter at phonedog_Aaron, Facebook, facebook.com/hiAaronBaker, and on Google Plus at phonedog.com/G+. Thanks so much for watching. Keep it locked right here for continuing coverage. And as always, I'll see you next time.